Ah, this is the life. No life-threatening adventures, no crazy puzzles to struggle through, no pesky foreshadows involving me fighting my way off a crashed train, hanging off of a cliff. Just me alone in a nice bar drinking a beer in this Mediterranean utopia. Wait a minute. Why isn't there a crowd of people here? Seriously, it's a really nice bar in a tropical paradise, so why am I the only one here? There's not even a bartender here, for God's sake. How'd I get this drink? Oh, I saw you steal it from the cooler, chump. Harry? Harry Flynn? Hey, you British slime bag. Hey, buddy, it's been a while, huh? It sure has, you stupid pile of seagull vomit. Yeah? So, how have you been? Great, you pansy-faced, crotch-smelling, awkward-toothed sea dog. You dim-witted, wretched, filthy, horrid, ugly-as-a-cow man-whore. That'll be enough. You fat, despicable, monkey's-ass piece of oh, shut up already! So I've been looking for you, mate. What for? Well, I've met a client that would be very interested in a special artifact. Here, check this out. The Travels of Marco Polo. Oh no, no, I refuse. I don't want to embark on another life-threatening adventure. Do you know how much blood, sweat, and tears I shed on my last adventure? Lots, Harry, lots. Particularly blood. I lost a little too much of that stuff, and I'm not willing to go through that hell again. Oh, it's not going to be a huge adventure, Nate. We're just going to break into a Turkish museum and steal a priceless artifact in a daring heist that will land us years in prison if we are caught. No stress at all. And I've recruited the help of a very dear friend to me. And here she is now. Oh, hello. Who's this flower? Nate, meet Chloe.
Pleased to meet you, Drake.
Hey, I don't know if you know this, but, I'm all for another adventure, Chloe, just as long as you're there, but, you know, for assistance, and, screw it. Wanna have sex?
Not gonna happen.
Meh, I tried. You sound like a guy anyway.
Okay, so here's how it's going to work. We go in through the sewers, into the courtyard, knock out some guards with some wicked awesome stealth moves, scale the walls, knock out some more guards, run across the rooftop, knock out more guards, and we drop down into the exhibit hall where I will betray you somehow and leave you for the mercy of the armed guards, Bob Jungle.
What was that last thing you said?
Drop down into the exhibit hall?
No.
Bob Jungle?
No, just before that.
I didn't say anything between those two statements.
Okay. Just clarifying, I should probably ask what this great artifact is, because my better morals are telling me that this is the wrong thing to do, and I don't know if I want to be a part of it.
Ah, yes, of course. Here it is. An oil lamp. It looks like a penis. Oh my god. Oh man. Okay, I'm in.
Yes, but it's more than just a lamp. It's a clue to a much greater treasure. Look at these files. They were written by Marco Polo, and they state that the lamp is the first step to finding a much greater treasure. We sought you out because you are the master, Nathan. We know that with your help, we can find this wealth.
Okay, okay, okay. I made those files. Well, it's some gay riddle, but I solved it. Marco Polo basically says that the treasure is located within a fleet of 13 ships that fell during his voyage.
So somewhere out there are 13 of these ships absolutely loaded with this treasure.
Shh. Men are talking.
You see, somewhere out there are 13 of these ships absolutely loaded with this treasure. Inside this penis lamp is the secret to the treasure that your client is looking for.
When we find this treasure, we're definitely going to dick this client out, aren't we?
Hell yeah!
Hell yeah! Hmm? Who could that be? Whoever it is, I'm sure there will be a dramatic sexual experience to follow.
Hello, handsome. May I come in?
Absolutely, hot stuff. Anytime. Just don't get any uglier.
That won't be hot. At least not when there's a strong, sexually stimulating man keeping me in order.
You know it.
At first, I didn't know what to think of you, Knight. But then my eyes were opened to your splendor. You strike me with so much vibrant energy that I cannot resist you.
That's right, honey. Don't you forget it.
You set my heart ablaze, Drake. Make me feel alive in ways that that fool Harry never can.
I won't disappoint you, sweetie.
And then after we find this treasure, let us run away and never return. Flynn will never bother us again, and we can have sex every night, starting right now.
Huh? What? Who the... Aw, it was a dream? Man, I was cock-blocked by my own mind. Stupid sexual fantasies.